Wake up, Elliot.
We there?
No, still a ways to go. But from here, we have to go on foot.
We've been in the car for 2 hours. You going to tell me why we're here?
Because we need to get there.
Come on, Jim.
Be patient. I told you it's a surprise. And I want you to find out for yourself. Or don't you like surprises?
I like them. Who doesn't? But what kind of surprise requires you to carry a gun?
Name me one thing you can do in Santa Esperanza without carrying a gun.
Touché.
Do as I say, and you'll see. Take it from Jim Dockers.
Because you're my friend, right?
Don't let your guard down. Have you heard of the Voduna cult?
You mean voodoo? Dolls and needles?
Yes and no. It's different varieties of the same thing. The Vodun religion from East Africa. In Cuba, they call it voodoo. In Haiti, it's voodoo. Santa Esperanza had its own version. A little community that lived in these woods, no more than 200 people, I reckon.
Had?
Right. They say practically all of them died. A sort of civil war sparked up by betrayal. Betrayal between friends.
Really? What kind of betrayal?
The Vodunas place particular importance on a person's name. They chose a name for themselves when they reached adulthood, and they only revealed it to their partners and their descendants.
Is that so?
It is. The legend says that while he was out hunting with his right-hand man, the chief of the Vodunas was attacked by...
Not such a dumb idea. I wish no one knew my name.
Well, for the Vodunas, it wasn't that simple. Ah, shit. Help me with this, Elliot. One, two, three. They had different names for day-to-day use. Nicknames similar to Indian names. Come on. Anyway, while he was out hunting, the chief of the tribe was attacked by a bear.
A bear? There were never any bears in Santa Esperanza.
Why are you talking in the past tense? I wasn't joking when I told you not to let your guard down.
Shit.
The chief's wounds look fatal, so he confided in his best friend. The best hunter in the tribe, and whispered his true name to him. The hunter left him in the woods, went back to the village, and told the news to the chieftain's wife and children.
Well, that's tough. However badly wounded he was his partner. You can't leave your partner in the woods, whatever state he's in.
Let's hope neither of us has to make that kind of decision today.
Sullivan River, flows into the Donovan Dam, I think.
I didn't think geography was your department.
Sometimes I like to dabble in things that aren't officially my department.
So I see. A According to Viduna law, from the moment the hunter whispered the dead husband's name to the chief's wife, he would take his place.
In what sense?
In the eyes of the tribe, he became him. He had to take on his role, fulfill his duties, raise his children, and sleep with his wife. Damn! Should be right here.
What?
The sign tells us which way we have to go. Must be hidden in the undergrowth.
Let me look for it.
Okay, I'll cover you.
This burned out a long time ago. Weeks, I guess. What kind of hunter abandons his trap when he leaves the woods? Animal attack, no doubt about it. Here's the sign. Looks like it was knocked over by a poacher's prey.
Well spotted. Let's go on.
You taking me to a church?
It's never a bad time to confess your sins. No idea.
Ah!
You are blocking my target. I'm sorry.
It's all right. Just a scratch.
Probably a splinter.
Are we going after whatever it was?
Let's not push our luck. I don't want our story to end up like the Viduna chieftain and the hunter.
Okay, let's go.
They built the chapel after the massacre of the Viduna people.
You still haven't told me how that happened.
The hunter became the chief and moved in with his family. It wasn't the first time that kind of thing had happened. But one thing did happen for the first time. The wounds the bear had inflicted on the real chief were less serious than they seemed. A few days later, he came back and claimed what was his. But the hunter wasn't so sure. He was the chieftain now.
Yes, but the hunter won his new identity by leaving the old chief to his fate.
He betrayed his friend, I agree with you. As did many of the Vidunas. But the rest of the village didn't see it that way. The Vadunas were split into supporters of the new chief and the old one. And, well, you know how it all ended. Elliot, I have a problem. I think Delphine is cheating on me with another man.
Whoa.
Some nights when I lie down next to her in bed, her hair smells of gunpowder. Someone who regularly handles guns is touching her. Do you have any idea who it could be?
That's impossible. Your wife would never do that to you. And what if you're getting the smell of powder on her yourself?
I wash my hands before I touch my wife, Elliot. Don't you?
Jim, please, put the gun down.
Yeah, Jim, put it down. You're late. You know why they built this chapel?
We know.
Typical Americans. They find that a bunch of crazies from some wacky religion have killed each other, and they build them a church, huh? As if the dead give a damn about their Christian God.
Jim, what's going on?
I told you, it's a surprise.
Who's going in?
He is.
Me?
Trust me.
You believe in godness?
Yeah, although I doubt splashing your face with water has much to do with it. Someone had some fun at these critters' expense. Mary Magdalene, the prostitute who repented and washed the feet of Christ.
I have a gun pointing at your head. I could kill you right now.
I'm not surprised. Today is International Point a Gun at My Head Day.
I won't shoot. I'm here to help you.
Yeah?
Look under your knees.
What is this?
To you. Just a bunch of scribbles. But to someone who knows what he's looking at, it could be prison bars for Capone.
What, he hates reading so much he sees a book as a prison sentence?
Very funny, Ness. Your financial specialist Garrison, you'll know what to do.
Why are you doing this?
What do you care? I'm serving you Capone's head on a golden plate. Don't ask questions. Just beat it, Ness. The sooner you set Garrison to work, the sooner all this will be over. Gotta hate cops.
Carmine?
Please, no.
Why?
He threatened my kids.
Capone? No, you're his right-hand man, his chief executioner.
He's lost his mind. He suspects everyone and everything. He has to be stopped. Don't kill me, for my kids' sake.
You remember Don Prescott? 33 years on the force, my first partner. You left his face in such a mess, they had to make him a clay mask so his family could look at him at the funeral.
Capone wanted him dead.
What about Amber Fisher, 15 years old? You held her prisoner for 3 days. She committed suicide only hours before we came to rescue her. I don't need to remind you what you did to her, do I?
I was following orders.
No. Capone orders you to kill. You improvise. You enjoy it.
You can't do this!
Elliot, don't do it. Kill an unarmed man and it'll haunt you your whole life.
I deserve a trial!
We're cops, not killers!
Jesus, Ness, weren't you...
Control your anger!
Weren't you the most honest man in Santa Esperanza?
Go back to Capone. Don't let him suspect a thing. And when I bring him to justice, you'll testify against him.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Ness. Thank you.
Well done. I made that mistake once. Only once. And it still torments me. Let's go.
Congratulations, Carmine. Great performance.
My kids.
Don't worry. I'm not going to touch them.
Thank you. Thank you.
I always keep my word.
If Capone finds out what you made me do, he'll kill me.
That won't happen. You have my word.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, I think Capone is going to need a new right-hand man.
Did Carmine get in touch with you? How did you do it?
It doesn't matter. Stroke of luck. Now, all we need to do is be careful. See what Garrison can find.
Jim, about Delphine?
Shut it. First we finish Capone. Then we talk.
Alone again, Ness? Wow, don't tell me your friends let you down again. Lucky you got me, huh?
I'm losing my mind.
It's only logical that doctors should abandon you. Although you denied it, it's obvious he knows you're screwing his wife. But what about the others? What will they think of you? how you lose touch with everyone, Ness. Or maybe it's just that anyone who gets close to you winds up dead. You should try to save her, right? The question is, can you? Do you even want to? It's funny. You don't mind giving half your earnings to some two-bit thief who walks into your restaurant, but when your friends are in danger...
No, please, no.
Wire was tapped. They broke into my house. Why did you get me mixed up in this?
Alice!
Billy, this is your fault. Get me out of here!
Hang on, Alice. I'll find you. Delphine, no! Not you!
I was followed, Elliot. From the diner. What are you mixed up in?
I see. You were breaking up with your secret sweetheart.
Delphine, no! Not you! Don't worry, Delphine. I'm coming!
You'll never learn, Elliot. You'll go on putting all the people you love in danger, won't you? Until you're completely alone.
Alphonse is taking care of that.
You knocked me out. You betrayed me.
Betrayed you? Since when were we partners?
Oh, where? Oh. East! Sophia!
What's going on up there?
That? I think it's modern art. Those things are supposed to be the pillars of Titus Andronicus's palace.
He's going to kill him.
Yeah, most likely. Says here, this is the Shakespearean tragedy that has the most deaths in it.
Talk, you bastard!
I don't... I'd say Capone is Titus, and Ivankov is Aaron, who ordered the kidnapping, rape, and mutilation of Titus's daughter, Lavinia. What do you think?
You son of a bitch! Talk! You... I'm wrong!
We can't let him kill him before he confesses.
I'm sorry, buddy, but what we can't do is to interfere in Alphonse's plans.
Remember what he did to Burke? In 5 minutes' time, Ivankov will be dead and your beloved Alphonse will never find his granddaughter.
Come on, you'll need help.
Let me explain.
Take a rest.
Al, I didn't do a thing. This is all a mistake, I swear.
Are you sure? Because what I found in your submarine makes me think otherwise.
What the fuck did you find?
You keep a register full of names. The names of people you sold to the Ku Klux Klan, to pimps like Abdulkader, or to slave traders.
All right, yes. I make people disappear. You don't know how hard it was to survive after you went away. Santa Esperanza went crazy. The cops, the judges, the other families, they all wanted to destroy your empire. I had to make a living.
What about the children?
What children? I never kidnapped a child. Never!
In your submarine, there's a container with mattresses barely a yard and a half long, and drawings of kids gunning down your men. Have you seen them?
Yes! For Christ's sake, yes!
I traffic in children too. Fuck!
I'll kill you.
But I never kidnapped your granddaughter, Al. Your family is my family.
I've also seen Boccherini's accounts. You paid him $2,500 for some forged papers. In the name of Guido Colombo.
Son of a bitch, let me go!
Steady, Alphonse.
It's a lie! It's a lie! He's a fucking cop! How can you believe him?
Take it easy, Alphonse. Take it easy.
I need a name. Just one name. Who asked for the girl? Who?
I don't know. I truly don't know.
I wish I could just kill you, Nikolai. But I have a reputation to think about. I prefer to do things differently. You help me, and I'll help you.
Yes. And how the fuck are you going to help me?
By now, your client knows we found you. What do you think they're going to do? Congratulate you? Tell me who they are, and we'll protect you.
You can't. I'll be found.
Maybe. Maybe not. Have you ever heard of my brother James?
You don't have a brother.
That's what I'm talking about.
I've never seen her. She told me to find 9 kids for her not long after Al went into the slammer. Not just any 9 kids. They were all the sons of criminals. Corrupt cops, murderers, rapists.
A woman?
She set up a meet in the caves at Rockford. In the darkness. I never saw her face. A week ago, she had me meet her again. The same place. The same assignment. Just like 20 years ago. But with new kids. Including Sophia Capone.
What else?
That's it.
There has to be more.
Maybe there's someone else who does business with her. Back in the day, I had a mole working undercover with the gravedigger's men.
You mean Elaine Ganella?
We were all spying on each other. We had to slice up the cake that Al had left behind. A few days after the assignment, Ganella took care of the bodies of 8 kids.
Oh dear God, not again. Did Ganella tell you why?
Aeneas?
This son of a bitch was behind the case that ended my career 20 years ago. The missing children were murdered. Why? Tell me why, you son of a bitch. Did she tell you?
No. Why should she? I don't usually fraternize with the competition. That is all. I am dead.
You have no idea.
You said that.
Screw everything I said.
I don't know what you think I did, but I'd never do anything.
Yeah, there you go, pussy. You don't have the guts to do shit. I don't know why I told you anything. I knew it was too much for someone like you.
Do something! No, please! No!
What the fuck?
His bodyguard.
He doesn't feel pain.
He's too strong.
Improvised weapon.
Ah! You! Rick! You're gone! Nelson!
Where do you buy those things?
He wasn't his bodyguard. He was his jailer.
Let's go. If that thing found us, there'll be more on the way.
All right. I'll go by the suite to pick up my things. Change of plan. I don't want my things anymore.
Where is Mr. Capone? Where is he?
There's no one by that name here, sir.
We have to help them.
What? That's suicidal. There's too many of them. And only Ness is carrying a gun.
You okay?
Thank you, Mr. Dias.
Let's go.
When he starts thinking, he'll scare you even more.
That's the boy who locked me up.
Right, Ness! Will you shut up?
Now.
You know this place better than me. Any other exits?
There's another cable car for emergencies.
Which way?
That way.
Are we all okay?
Yeah.
For the time being.
kissed on their graves and flowers grew.
And turns, huh?
In people's minds.
Let me try something.
We're not gonna get out of here. So what's the secret ingredient?
We'll get out of here. We have to keep moving.
Shame.
Which way?
That way! The service entrance!
Let's go.
On our tail.
We have to get to the cable car, start it, and wait till it reaches us.
Oh, I don't believe it. Come on!
Visit a relic!
Damn!
You remember the November 9th massacre? I arranged a meet with Leo Maldonati in the garage on 72nd and Main. I was alone, but the son of a bitch turns up with 30 men. Fortunately, I brought along one of these beauties. You should have seen the faces on those jakes.
Elliot!
Start it up!
Do it!
Not bad for a couple of has-beens, huh?
Whew! How many did we kill?
More than I've seen in 13 years. Now for some food and... protect him.
Pleasure to have you as a partner, Sugar Kid.
Ray! Oh God. Oh God, Ray. Oh God.
No use crying. We have to focus on finding your granddaughter.
He saved my ass several times. Literally. And I don't need to tell you what a big shot mafioso keeps his ass for when he goes into jail. He saved me.
Looks like it's clear. Let's go.
Is this dump safe?
It'll have to do. Besides, they're looking for you. They may not have recognized me. That hurt?
Now what do you think?
Come on, quit belly aching. You're a big boy now.
Screw you, Ness. I'm in no mood for jokes.
What is this?
What the fuck?
Holy Christ.
It's not fair. It's your fault I'm like this. It was your fault. If you hadn't snitched on me, it wouldn't have happened. I was going to be punished. What was I meant to do? It was your stupid fault. If you'd have been quicker, we'd have escaped. Whatever. Who cares anyway? I don't have a hand. They don't feed me. And they gave you a puppy. It's not fair.
I haven't eaten anything either since, I don't know when, a long time. Neither is Groucho. Poor little thing is so hungry. He's just a puppy.
And they cut off my hand. I don't feel good. I don't want to die.
We'll get out. You wait and see.
I hope so. I miss my mom and dad, and my brother, and my toys. Will you let me play with Groucho?
He needs to rest. He's very weak and...
Don't be afraid. I have come to bring a present for your little doggy.
His name is Groucho.
Give it to her. The milk will do him good. He has to grow. He needs to get big and strong. What do we say?
Thank you.
No. Thank you, honey, for being such a good girl. Let's go.
Give it to me, please. I need it more. It's just a dog.
I'm sorry, Groucho. You'll leave a little for him, won't you?
Sure. Groucho, look! I have your milk. You want some? Come over here. Easy. Easy. We don't want you to choke. Groucho, if you cry, I'll have to punish you.
You're hurting him!
You asked for this. The milk isn't enough.
Yeah.
They met 20 years ago.
Elliot, whose side are you on?
Looks like someone's tying up loose ends for me.
Tell me straight, you killed him, didn't you?
He was eaten alive.
Put those instincts to work, Ness. Just when I thought we were getting closer to Sophia.
He kills them at the end. He seems determined to carry out this ritual on individuals with connections to the underworld.
You said you'd find her, Ness. That you'd save her. That you'd bring her back to me.